lights on. Let me open it to you. What do you want me to talk about? Tell me. Shout out a few things. Come on. Art of living. Come on. You don't need me to talk about art of living. Just look at me. That's it. Beg your pardon? Mind? Mind balance. Okay. That's one. Okay. What else? Colors. All right. What else?
Emotions.
Okay. Okay, God. All right. You know, you guys are like almost asking me to talk about what I had planned to talk about. Maybe it's the kurta pajama and the long hair that does it. Okay, so since this talk, the theme of the TED is about excellence, right? Excellence happens when things over here work the way they should, right? So what exactly are the things over here? What are we carrying along with us? Yeah, when you take birth, when you come onto this planet, what do you come with? Well, the first thing is the body, yeah, and this piece of organic technology is something really amazing. You know, if you start going inside the skin and start looking at the systems that are there in your body, that can be 25 TED Talks all by themselves. Yeah. For example, did you know that your brain weighs 1.5 kilos, and it is given blood by two little arteries called the carotid arteries, right? If you touch here, you will feel the pulse, right? So you've got two carotid arteries giving blood to your brain, which is basically keeping you alive. Now 1.5 kilos of weight on two little tubes. Not possible, really. It's not possible, right? So the angel in heaven, they had a conference. अभी बना तो दिया, लेकिन ऑन करता है तो ऑफ हो जाता है. What to do? Well, they injected a little bit of water, cerebrospinal fluid, it's called. And because of that, what happens is your brain floats. Did you know your brain floats in your head? Isn't that cool? Right? And because it floats, it weighs only 200 grams. So life works. You have 100 billion neurons in your brain. 100 billion. Yeah? And each of these 100 billion neurons have between 2,000 to 10,000 dendrites floating out of them. And those 2,000 to 10,000 dendrites interact with each other in more permutations and combinations than there are elementary particles in the universe. You've got God sitting right here. Yeah? So that's the body. Then we have the mind, what we call the mind. Yeah? And body is very solid. You can feel it. Mind, pata nahi, hai, nahi, hai, hai, hai. Itna to pata hai, lekin kahan hai, pata nahi. Right? So mind kya karta hai na? Past aur future mein jaate rehta hai. It oscillates between the past and the future. Have you noticed this happening? Have you noticed it happening right now while I was talking? Huh? What are we going to have for lunch? How much longer am I supposed to sit here? Right? You know, a neuroscientist friend of ours, he said that the state of your bum is the same as the state of your head. If your bum is feeling squashed and tired, then your head is feeling the same. Yeah, I was actually going to get you guys. Okay, why don't we just get up? Everybody stand up. Let's fix the state of the bum first. Okay, come on, Dinesh. Dinesh is the exerciser. He wears the kurta so you can't see the biceps. Come on, everybody, stretch. Ugh. Like you just woke up. Maybe you did. Shake up. Shake, 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 shake. Shake the bum. That's the part you want to fix.
Hips don't lie.
Okay, now please sit. Do you notice you're feeling good? Yes? Do you know why? It's to do with your brain again. Turns out, if you look back a little bit, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000 years ago, our body was meant to move. Right? Because basically, either we were running away from something that wanted to eat us, or we were running after something we wanted to eat. Right? And if your body didn't know how to move, you would die. So the brain has an inbuilt mechanism in it that whenever you move your body, whenever you do some sort of movement, some sort of exercise, it releases something called endorphins. And endorphins make you feel good. Have you seen how people walk out of the gym? Right? It makes you feel like you're in control, like you're the boss. Yeah? Physiologically speaking, when you exercise, you get a boost. Another amazing thing about exercise is it gives you a younger brain. Did you know that? You know, we started out with those 100 billion neurons, but there are a lot of these electrical, chemical activities that are going on in the brain, right? Now, if there is so much of zzzz happening, something is going to get fried, right? So every minute you are losing a few neurons, and neurons are the only cells in the body that do not replicate, right? And so it was thought that as you grow older, you work with 100 billion minus X neurons, where X is consistently increasing. And until the early 2000s, it was thought that once you lose a neuron, it's gone, finished. But turns out that when you exercise, there's a part in your brain called the hippocampus which actually generates new neurons. And a whole new field of neuroscience has come, which is called neurogenesis. Yeah? So when you exercise, not only do you feel good, your body feels great, but you get a younger brain. Cool, no? Yeah? So that's the mind. Then we have the breath. The breath is the thing that connects the body and the mind. Think of all the things that you want in life. Come on, everybody. I give you 10 seconds. Everything you want in your life, think about it. Just think about it and know that you're going to get it. So think about it properly. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thought about all of that? All those things you want? Yes? No, you didn't think about it. You want another 10 seconds. Okay. Think of all those things that you have always wanted and put them on one side and put your breath on the other side. What would you choose? When was the last time you thought about breathing? The most important aspect of ourselves is also the most neglected aspect of ourselves. Right? That's the whole science of pranayam. Pranayam is using the breath to marry the body with the mind. Amazing. It's amazing. When, you know, we cannot even start talking about it. I can just give you a little pshht like that about it. Yeah. So that's pranayam. Come on. Shall we do one quick pranayam? Okay. Everybody put your hands like that in front of you. Okay. Sit up straight. Keep your feet firmly on the floor. Okay. And when you breathe in with force. And then out. And if some ghee comes out of the nose, don't worry. Okay? Come on, again. Jor se. And relax. See how you feel? Some tingling started? Yes? That's the prana. Okay? That's the subtle energy that you start feeling. Okay, so this particular pranayama is called Bhastrika. Yeah, and it's also, we call it the power breath. If you're feeling tired, just sit and do Bhastrika 20 times. Yeah, instantly you will start feeling energized. Okay, so body, mind, breath, intellect. What's the intellect for? What do you think the intellect is for? Some idea? Huh? Deciding whether it's right or wrong. Deciding whether it's good or bad. It's for discrimination, right? But typically we use it for doubting. Have you noticed that? Huh? And it's amazing what we doubt. We doubt only the good things. Isn't it? Someone comes and tells you, you are a bloody idiot. You don't doubt that. So when you are that age, you kind of know almost everybody around you of that age, and you get this nice sensation of outstripping the competition, so to speak. You know, so every Sunday morning she will be having her chai and saying, "Arey arey arey, bichara mari gaya. Arey arey arey, what a lady she was. Oh, he was such a gentleman." Like that, it would go on. You know, half an hour, pure bliss as far as she was concerned. Now, once in the middle of the arey arey areys, she suddenly goes, "Saru thayu, mui mari gayu." Which in Gujarati, this is Gujarati, it is roughly translated into English, it means good, the bitch is dead. What did you just say? Yes, 1969 she had insulted me. She's dead. Now you are laughing, but isn't that exactly what you do? Bara dekh leta hu tere. Yaad rakhunga. Are kya yaad rakhunga? कितना पकड़ के बैठोगे? Do you get it? Memory. Again with children, not a problem. Yeah, I mean, you just imagine this. Huh? You're sitting there watching your news or watching your World Cup or watching your IPL or whatever it is that you are watching on TV, which you are really interested in. And someone comes and shuts the TV and says, "Go to bed." What will you do to that person? And isn't this what we routinely do to our kids? They're sitting there watching their Cartoon Network or something and like, "Thak, ban, chalo, khana khao." Okay? See, kids don't have these long-term memories that adults seem to develop. And again with the memory, what do we remember? All the bad things. Someone says, "Oh, you are so wonderful, you are so beautiful, your eyes are lovely, your hair is fantastic, but your nose? What's wrong? I mean, your nose really spoils everything." What do you go and do? Look in the mirror, "What's wrong with my nose?" And who is he to talk about noses anyway? Right? 10 compliments, 1 insult, what do you remember? And then you say, "Oh, I am so miserable in life." No? Intellect se doubt karte ho. Memory to exam crack mara. Engineering mein aaye, ye yaad nahi hai. Last quiz mein flunk mar diya, ye yaad hai. Hai na? Pakad pakad ke apne aap ko dukhi karna. One of my teachers used to say, you know, when people throw a ball of shit at you know what you do? You dive and catch it. And then you apply it on your face. And say, "Oh my God, my face is spoiled." And whatever is left over, you take it and put it in a safe deposit vault. So every time you are feeling good, you open it and shit. Body, breath, mind, intellect, memory. The sixth level is very interesting. It's the ego. It's the sense of I am. Right? And there are 3 types of ego. The first is the inclusive ego. Let us all move together. Sangha Chhatva. Vasudeva Kutumbakam. The whole world is my family. Right? Let us all move together. This is the inclusive ego. The second is the competitive ego. I am better than you. Yeah, this is how the world works more or less. Right? My father is better than yours. Starts there. Right?
Some people take it to ridiculous extremes. It doesn't matter. It's still okay. The competitive ego is still okay. But the third is the destructive ego. It's the ego of the terrorist. Not only will I kill you, I will kill myself. I will destroy. And in that destruction, if I get destroyed, it doesn't matter. And many times it is not just terrorism, it could be a relationship. Both people are utterly miserable. Both are screwing each other's happiness. Right? The destructive ego, the competitive ego, and the inclusive ego. People say ego is bad. I don't say ego is bad. Ego is part of you. Right? When you say I, that is ego. There's nothing wrong with ego. The point is you should know when to use the inclusive ego and when to use the competitive ego. Where what will fit is very important. And of course, you don't use the destructive ego at all. Right? And then the seventh level is what we call the self. Who you truly are. Right? And this cannot be defined. It can only be negated. So we say you are not the body. You're not the breath, you're not the mind, you're not the intellect, not the memory, you're not the ego. You remove all that, what is left is who you are. Right? And this state is the meditative state. It's what we teach. How to get there. Now there are four states of consciousness. The first is awake. Everybody awake?
Yes.
Please snap your fingers. Very good. If you're snapping your fingers, I know you're awake. Right? Okay. The second, so in the awake state, there is rest. Sorry. In the awake state, there is awareness, but there is no rest. Right? If you stay awake for too long, you feel tired. The second state is the sleep state. Sleep, there is rest, but no awareness. And the third state is the dream state. In dream state, there is neither rest nor awareness. Isn't it? You cannot, you wake up in the morning and say, aaj raha fresh nahi lag raha hai. Bahut sare vichar the, too many thoughts, too many dreams, couldn't sleep too well. Neither rest nor awareness. In the fourth state, you have rest and awareness. And it is my personal theory that in a few generations, maybe an institution like the Art of Living will be out of business because people will be born with the ability to meditate. Just as people are born with the ability to stay awake, sleep and dream, the fourth state of consciousness will be hardwired into our DNA. Because meditation is basically override. It overrides the evolutionary response of the brain. When you are feeling threatened, the brain goes into fight or flight. Right? Meditation allows you to override that. See, originally in the jungles and all that, when a tiger is in front of you, you cannot stand and think, "Arey, acha, abhi bhage, kya kare?" You can't do that. It's a split second decision that needs to be taken. Fight or flight. Either I run or I fight. And for that, what needs to happen is all the blood from your stomach goes into the extremities and you get ready to fight or flight. Right? That's an evolutionary response the brain does. Okay? When you meditate, you can override that. Because the brain doesn't really know what is danger when you are standing in front of an audience and not prepared? Your PowerPoint doesn't work, your keynote doesn't work. It's oh my god. Right? It doesn't know that from a tiger. So it basically says run. But when you are a meditator, you can say, look, it's not a threat anymore. It's not a threat. I can handle this. Chill. And so the body produces these feel-good hormones called serotonin and oxytocin. It keeps you in control of the situation. Okay. To end, I'd like to give you an experience of serotonin and oxytocin. Serotonin and oxytocin are called the happiness hormones. Alright. So, what I want you to do is turn around to your partner, whoever, aage piche, and shake their hands for 20 seconds, looking at them in their eyes. Look at them and shake their hands. Come on. Everybody, three people can join in if required. Go on, look at each other, don't look at me. Look at each other. Yeah. Now, if you really like them, you can give them a hug if you want. Come on, give them a hug. Okay.
Okay. How are you feeling? You're feeling good, no? You are feeling actually ridiculously good. Yeah? It is a scientific fact, a hardcore scientific fact, that when you have physical contact with someone you like and they like you, for more than 10 seconds, your brain goes, yes, I love this. Okay? And it floods you with this serotonin and oxytocin, all the happiness hormones, and you feel good. Okay? And by the way, this effect lasts for around 3 hours. So it's perfect to do just before lunch. Now you can network and crack those deals. Jai Gurudev. Bye.